Milk Carton Boat Race this weekend. It's part of the Rose Festival events, and it's a decades-old tradition.
Are you sure?
You messed me up because you were messing with my prompter.
Moi? I can't imagine.
Weird.
Drew-Carney is live at Westmoreland Park.
She's
You're
trolling
getting ready
me.
To write. I'm trying to stay on track. I'm trying to be the professional.
As the coaches.
Please.
As the coaches of my son's 9-year-old baseball team will say, I don't want to hear about excuses.
Oh.
Just do your job.
See?
Wow.
That's how they talk to the 9-year-olds. here we are with some above 9-year-olds this morning on Westmoreland Park's casting pond, and we're all floating by way of milk carton boats. Yes, these are boats that float only by means of recycled milk carton and jugs. And you can participate in this annual milk carton boat race come Sunday afternoon here at Westmoreland Park. I have, among others, with me the Prime Minister of the Royal Rosarians, Jim Stahl. I have right behind me, she will help me paddle here in a moment, she is Danielle, an Oregon Dairy Princess Ambassador. We have Brian Snook. The Snook family has captured many a medal at the annual milk carton boat races. We also have Sea Scouts with us this morning. The Sea Scouts will help people stay safe on these waters Sunday. Now, the event itself starts at 11 a.m. Registration day of, if you want to come down here with a milk carton boat that you make yourself, you can come down. 9:30 is what the encouraged time would be for early registration. That way you can participate in the races. Jim Stahl, last year the Royal Rosarians took over this decades-old event, and you're putting it on now. You participated as a young boy.
Yes.
You're now helping to run the event. Paint the picture for those who have never participated or come to this event.
Well, this is really a beautiful facility here, and we just fill this entire area up with visitors, people that come and sit along the water and watch this event happen. We've got all the boaters lined up over here, and then they race across over here to the finish line, and a lot of people get to sit here on a nice cool day and enjoy the view and enjoy the cool waters of the afternoon.
Now, let's talk about racing. In fact, we shouldn't talk about racing. We should race. Are you ready, milk carton boaters? On your marks, get set. Get ready, Danielle, we're about to win something here. And go, and we're off and running. Westmoreland Park, again, the place to be Sunday for the annual milk carton boat races. The dairy farmers of Oregon, this event for many years. They still support this event. That is why I have the Oregon Dairy Princess Ambassador with me on the water. And Rod Hill, never mind the fact that we're kind of losing right now. I'm about to crash into a Sea Scout. Back, young man. Rod Hill, I was talking to Jim, our Royal Rosarian Prime Minister. We noticed the number 101 on the forecast.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
In terms of degrees come Sunday.
Yes.
But I was talking to Jim, I said, he shouldn't be concerned about that. 101, that'll be the temperature, I'm guessing, at the airport at about 5 o'clock on Sunday afternoon. Westmoreland Park, 11 a.m. Sunday. What do you think, Rod? 75 degrees?
No, I think,
how about it?
I think Eastmoreland will be 101. Westmoreland, probably about 62. Yeah.
Hey, Jim, good news. Rod says Eastmoreland, 101. Westmoreland, 60s.
It's perfect.
Somewhere in between.
We're out of time, guys.
If that's true, there'd be white caps on that little pond right there. It would be so windy as the atmosphere worked between that sharp temperature divide.
Oh, thank you, guys. Looks like fun.
Oh, that's a fun event every single summer. We look forward to that. Yeah.